Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to perform complex file searches on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon where you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. Probably the quickest way to search your Mac is to use Command Space to bring up Spotlight and use a Spotlight search. But this is going to bring up lots of things that aren't files. You're going to see web pages, emails, all sorts of stuff. If you want to just see files, then your best bet is to start in the Finder. So have any Finder window open and you've got the search box here and you can start typing in that and that will just search for files. If you use Command F though, which is File, Find, then it instantly switches into this searching mode which has a few more options. First thing you want to pay attention to is make sure you're searching in the right area. You always have the current location, wherever it was that this window was pointing at before you hit Command F, in this case the Documents folder. So make sure you know this is where you want to search. If you want to search up in the User folder level, start there. If you want to search down inside of a specific folder, start there. You're only going to get files that are in here. If you select this Mac, you're going to search your entire computer and usually you don't want to do that because that means it's going to search system files, library files, all sorts of things where you know the file that you created is not going to be located. So start at the proper location and then you still have this field up here and this is where you can type your search term. So you can type a file name or part of a file name. For instance, I can start typing test and what I'm going to get are a lot of documents that have the word test in the title but some documents that don't. They have test in the contents. But notice under here I get this little option to limit the search to only documents that have the word inside the name. Now I could further refine the search here. I've got this search criteria area and it just has one item in it right now and that is kind is any. In other words anything. But this allows me to refine this. So I can say kind is oh just give me text documents. And now I've refined it like that. And you can refine it any way you want. I can do presentations, I can do music, I can do folders with that name. So right away I can refine the search and make it much more powerful. I could add more to this so I could hit the plus button here and add another item to the criteria. So for instance I could do kind is text. I can further refine and say do I want plain text, rich text, you know what type of text here. And I could say name matches so I can further refine the name or I can choose something else. Like for instance the last open date is within the last 300 days. And you can see that narrows it down to 3 files. Now I've got 2 pieces of criteria here. One is the kind is text and the other is last open date. So it's going to and those. It's going to give me files where both those conditions are true. But what if I want to have either one of those conditions true? So I'm going to use the minus button to remove this condition here. So if I hit the plus button I can add another item to the criteria here and it will give me any files that match both of those. But if I hold the Option key down I get 3 dots. I click that and now I have 2 lines. The first one says any of the following are true and I can change any to all or none. And then I have a line underneath it that's indented. And I can set that to anything I want. So let's say last open date is within the last 300 days. But I could add another one here that's also indented under this any and say the file size is greater than 1K. So now it's going to look for either one of these to be true. So I'll get files that are both within the last 300 days and files that are greater than 1K in size. I can change that to all and it kind of makes it the same as if these weren't indented. I only get files that have both of these conditions. I can also say none. So I only get files that will not match either of these 2 conditions. So this makes it much more powerful to be able to have this of the following are true statements here. And you can nest these. So I can create another one here underneath this. So I can make this any of the following are true and then one of the items here is all of these have to be true. So this makes it very powerful. And you can use this with name as well. So I can get rid of name there now that I have some items. So now it's not going to try to match any name but I could do things like the name begins with the letter A and the name begins with the letter B and I'm going to get files that start with the letter A or the letter B. If I change it to all, I'm going to get nothing because there's no such thing as a file that starts with both those letters. And if I switch to none, I'm going to get files that do not have A or B at the beginning. So there you can see when I sort alphabetically, I get C and on. Now going beyond that, you have more options than just name, last open date, etc. here. You can go to other and you're going to get a huge list of rules that you could add. A lot of these apply to metadata in video and audio files and also photos as well. So you're going to get things like genre for genre of music, ISO speed for photos, things like that. There's some interesting things in here including the ability to do a raw query, and I have a whole video on how to use that. Anyone that you see in here you can easily add to that main list. So for instance, I can do number of items, which is something that you can use to search for folders that have more than a certain number of items in them. So I can select that one. I can hit OK and it now changes to number of items. But I could also go back here to other and I could find that number of items and say that's something I want to use all the time. I could check the checkbox there and now number of items appears here in the list. You could also search in here. So for instance, if you know you want to search for images by width, for instance, I can type width and sure enough there's page width for documents, pixel width, and resolution width. So I can do pixel width here and I can search for images greater than say 1,000 pixels. So photos, maybe look for things that are less than 1,000 to see some clip art that I've got. You can get really creative with what you choose here from this list of criteria for very specific searches. If you have a search that you've carefully put together with lots of items here and you want to save it, you can hit the save button and what it's going to do is save a smart folder as a saved search file. It'll save it in your library folder under save searches and allow you to add it to the sidebar if you want. Or you could just save it anywhere you want. You can save it into your documents folder and when you open up that saved search it will instantly give you back the criteria list that you have here. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.